3 and 04, and I was standing on a similar stage of this with Nick Reynolds on my left and John Stewart on my right. And we did Reuben James one year, and the next year we did MTA, the video of which is easily available on YouTube. Give it some more. It only has 10,000 views. I want more. Anyway, it was a lot of fun. It was the fulfillment of a childhood dream. But I want to tell you that those two moments were neither more special nor more electric to me than this one is here right now. I feel that the dream on this stage with Rick Dougherty here and George Grove over here is every bit the equivalent of those other two fantasy games. I've gotten to know Rick over the last 7 years. I knew of his work, but I've gotten to know him. And aside from having, okay, for my money, the best pure tenor voice of the entire folk era, comparable only to Chad Mitchell. That's one and one answer. What you all know about him, but needs to be said, he has an incredible generosity of spirit. If you're a camper or have been, you know this. But it's not just on display there. You know the old vaudeville joke, what does the mailman do on his day off? He doesn't take a walk. Okay? Well, after putting in 8-hour days, helping campers do their thing, become better, singing, blowing the roof off the place like he did the last couple nights, what does Rick do? He takes a walk. He goes over to the suites virtually every night. Hostility Suite, Mike and Mikey's Suite. He is the best audience a musician could have because he's really appreciating it. And when it calls for it, if it's a moment that calls for it, he will lend that golden voice to whatever song is being sung. Regularly. It's true. It's true. Don't make a liar out of me. Okay. I'm sorry, who are you talking about? For an artist that great, that kind of generosity is very uncommon. Now this guy over here. Yeah. Well, let's just start the song. That would be a good idea. I got to spend 4 weekends with George in Big Bear, California. With a quartet made up of George, me, Art Podello, the Christy Minstrels, and Joe Frazier. And in those 4 hours on successive Saturdays, I learned more about performance than I did in 60 years of being a musician. Okay, George has, like Rick, an uncommon quality. All great professionals have this. Doctors, teachers, lawyers, bus drivers. George makes everybody around him better. And he doesn't do it by shouting or kicking, he's gonna kick me here in a moment, but by kicking you or giving you an order. He does it by committing himself totally to the music that he's making. And that sends out electric shock waves across any stage he's on that lifts the performance into the stratosphere. He's also a hell of a guy. And I say without he's the greatest musician I've ever known, and I love him, and I am proud to say he is my friend. So why the hell did my two friends have to do this song last night? This is a John Stewart song, and just your piece of teacher's trivia for the day. If they didn't know, John Stewart did not write the introduction. The introduction you're going to hear was done by Jerry Walter of the Gateway Singers at John's request. Gonna do New Frontier.
Some to the rivers and some to the sea, some to the soil that our fathers made free, then on to the stars and the heavens for to see. This is the New Frontier. This is the New Frontier.
Like the words of hope, from this day on, a new generation has been born. Born to the past to keep us free, but proud of the rights of the whole country.
This is the New Frontier. This is the New Frontier. Some to the rivers and some to the sea, some to the soil that our fathers made free, then on to the stars and the heavens for to see.
wind, or shall take long, that every man sing our freedom song. Not for ourselves we take this stand, now it's the world that the freedom of men. This is the new frontier, this is the new frontier. The day will come, it's got to be the day that we may